today's topic is study of compounds and nitric acid we will discuss. Nitric acid, it is represented as HNO3, and this one it is strong mineral acid, strong mineral oxyacid, and here as it has one replaceable hydrogen atom, that is why it is monobasic, monobasic acid. Okay, and here this relative molecular mass is 63. It is 63. Okay, now this HNO3, also known as aqua fortis, this one is also known as aqua fortis. It means that one, it is a strong water, means that it is strong water. Why it is strong water? Because it react with all metals, all metals except gold and platinum. Okay, it reacts even silver also, it dissolves in aqua fortis. And HNO3 is present both in the free state and in the combined state. So first of all, let us see how it is possible in the free state. So free state means whenever there will be lightning condition, in the lightning condition, atmospheric nitrogen react with oxygen in the lightning condition, and it give rise to NO. Okay, and here one thing is nitrogen, it is almost non-reactive. Under certain condition only it will react. See, in case of Haber's process, we are taking nitrogen under temperature, pressure, catalyst, it give rise to ammonia. Here also the same thing, nitrogen react with oxygen in lightning condition to give rise to NO, nitric oxide. This NO along with oxygen, as oxygen is present, no? So give rise to NO2. So here two, okay, this NO2. And third step is that in this NO2, in presence of oxygen, obviously whenever lightning, soon after that one, almost cases there is rain. So with that rain or water, it dissolve in here and give rise to HNO3. So here this one will be 4-2 water and 4 HNO3. So this is present in the free state in the lightning condition. Okay, and here another one, how it is present in the combined, I hope you understand this one. Some cases question comes, write the equation for the formation of this HNO3 under lightning condition. So nitrogen with oxygen, so three step equation, first of all NO will be formed, second step NO2 will be formed, then HNO3 will be formed. So this one in the free state. How it is will be the combined state? All this nitrate in the combined state, all nitrate, it is formed in the form of nitrate. So that one in the combined state. Now we will go for laboratory preparation of HNO3. So this is that arrangement that we have taken. First of all, let us see. Here this nitric acid can be obtained by distilling concentrated sulfuric acid with KNO3 or NaNO3, sodium nitrate or potassium nitrate. So here what should be the reactants? So reactants are concentrated H2SO4, and here you can take KNO3 or NaNO3. Now let us go for this equation. So here this KNO3 or NaNO3, sodium nitrate or potassium nitrate, along with concentrated sulfuric acid, this one should be equimolar. Same weight we have to take, and here have to take that mixture can be taken in the glass retort. Okay, here this one can be the combination of H2SO4 plus NaNO3. Now let me write this equation. So here KNO3 plus H2SO4, here concentrated, this concentrated is must. We have to heat it outside, and we have to see that we have we are heating it, but under such means very low amount of heat can be supplied to it. It should be less than 200 degrees Celsius. Actually, favorable condition, favorable temperature is 100 to 200 degrees Celsius. So what happens in this case? In this case, we are getting KHSO4 plus HNO3. And this is the best reaction, no balancing, nothing required. Okay, so whenever it is we are taking this one and we are heating it from outside, now these vapors of HNO3 are formed, and these vapors of HNO3 are it is raised here, then it can be taken outside. Not taken means the vapors of nitric acid which are evolved, so will be collected in this container. Okay, and here as those are in the vapor form, we have to cool and we have to pour this cold water. So when cold water is poured here, then these vapors they will condense and they will be in the form of liquid. Okay, so this is that entire apparatus, then apparatus designing. Then here whenever we are taking this condition, why less than 200 it is taken? So now let us see here why less than 200 is preferred. Here temperature should be is favorable is less than 200 degrees Celsius. Why it is less than 200 degrees Celsius it is taken? Here what happens, at high temperature, at high temperature, HNO3 formed, this HNO3 may decompose to form NO2. Okay, so here in this case, to avoid this one, temperature it is taken less than 200. This is the first one. Second one, what is that? When greater than 200 degrees Celsius we are taking, the reaction KNO3 plus H2SO4, this one will be concentrated. Greater than 200 degrees Celsius, what is the product? K2SO4 along with HNO3 is formed. Okay, so when this one will be K2SO3, so here this one will be 2, this one will be 2, NO3, HNO3, 2, H2, so this one will be 2, okay, so this K2SO4, whatever it is formed, this one will be the hard crust, this is the hard crust. Which one will be here in this container? This side, all this will be stick. So whenever it is sticking to this one, and heat, whatever heat it is supplied, it will not reach to the reactor hard crust. Okay, so heat, so let me rub this one. Okay, so heat will not reach to the mixture. Okay, and second thing, it is heat is wasted, energy is wasted, heat is wasted. Second one, it is this apparatus may break. Then apparatus may crack or this one can break. That is the reason only why it is not taken greater than 200. So here K2SO4 or Na2SO4 will be formed here. As a result, this heat cannot reach here. Heat will be wasted, or fuel heat or fuel will be wasted. Okay, apparatus may crack because it is more temperature we are providing, then this one may crack. So this is the reason why temperature it is taken less than 200 degrees. So then next one, it is all the apparatus are made up of glass. So this one it is important. Give reason question. So here, okay, why this arrangement or apparatus is made up of glass? Why it is made up of glass? Because this HNO3, it is corrosive in nature. HNO3 is corrosive in nature. So it corrodes cork. Okay, so this is the reason only why it is it means the vapors of HNO3. Okay, whatever HNO3 will be evolved, no, it is collected, that one will be covered. So here this glass retort, it is made up of this one, it is glass, this one also it is glass. Because this vapors of nitric acid, highly corrosive, attack rubber, cork, all these things. Okay, that is why this apparatus, it is completely made up of glass. Then let us see another one here. When we are collecting this nitric acid, it is collected here. This one will be pure nitric acid. Pure HNO3 is colorless. Pure nitric acid is colorless. But laboratory preparation, whatever nitric acid we are getting or collected in laboratory, this HNO3 collected is yellow is in color. And here one only the impurities present in this nitric acid is impurity present in nitric acid is NO2. Okay, this is the only this impurity present, and due to this present of NO2, this looks yellowish in color. Okay, here we can write it is the color due to presence of NO2. What is the color of NO2? Color of NO2 is reddish brown in color. Okay, so here whenever there will be decomposition, so NO2, it will change this color to yellow is in color. Now question arises, from where we are getting NO2? Now if temperature regulation we are giving more temperature, then HNO3 decomposes to give rise to NO2, and this NO2 will be there to produce. Means here this HNO3, when it is heated, temperature will be little more, or it is heated, we cannot write it because we are heating this. So here it can be NO2 along with water, along with oxygen. So let us balance this one. This one will be 4, NO2 will be 4, water will be 2. Okay, so this NO2 present will change this colorless liquid to yellowish in color. Now let us see how this yellow color can be removed. Okay, this yellow color can be removed. Can be removed by first one. It can be by bubbling air or carbon dioxide by bubbling air. You can take or carbon dioxide into HNO3. Or this solution where HNO3 will be there. So here, what happens in this case? Whenever this air or carbon dioxide will be bubbled here, will be bubbled, it drives out. This carbon dioxide drives out NO2, and this NO2 further oxidizes HNO3. Okay, so here this carbon dioxide drives out NO2 from this solution, or you can say the mixture. This NO2 again produces, again oxidizes with water, again oxidizes to produce HNO3. That is the reason only why it is this carbon dioxide is bubbled. Another one form it can be also this. Second form is that here by dilution with water. So here we have discussed everything, but one thing I have forgotten to tell you. Here we are using concentrated H2SO4. What is the reason behind it? Why we are taking concentrated H2SO4? So the main reason is that this H2SO4, it is non-volatile. It is non-volatile. Non-volatile means it has high boiling point. Here 338 degree. Here 338 degree Celsius boiling point. Just imagine. Due to its high boiling point only, this concentrated H2SO4, it is used. Now question arises, can we use this concentrated HCl? Can we use? No. Concentrated HCl cannot be used. Why it is cannot be used? Because it is highly volatile. This one is highly volatile. This concentrated HCl or HCl itself highly volatile. Highly volatile means it has low boiling point. Okay, so due to this volatile nature only, HCl cannot be used. And here, whatever KNO3 or NaNO3 you are using along with H2SO4 concentrated, this one should be equimolar. Means 1:1 ratio. This one should be 1:1 ratio should be taken. Okay, so entirely let us have a revision for it. Now in this laboratory preparation, fundamental things for it? What we are taking? First of all, temperature should be less than 200 degree or should be low temperature. Okay, second one, concentrated H2SO4 is used. Why this one? It is non-volatile. This one is non-volatile. What is the third one? Concentrated HCl is not used. Okay, this one it is volatile. What is the fourth one? All apparatus is made up of glass. Why? Because the vapors of HNO3 corrodes cork and rubber. Okay, so next point here, this temperature of fifth point, this one will be fifth point. So temperature, if temperature we are taking greater than 200 degree Celsius, this Na2SO4 will be formed, which is a hard crust. This one it is hard crust, this one stick to the wall of the container. Wall of the container. Okay. Second one, it is fuel is wasted. The most important thing is that HNO3 decomposes to NO2. This decomposes to NO2. This is the main reason for it. Then here fifth point it is, what is all these are the points, entirely summary. This is the summary. And here pure HNO3 is colorless. So the pure HNO3, it is colorless. But HNO3 prepared in lab is yellowish in color. Yellowish in color due to presence of NO2. Due to presence of NO2. Okay. Then seventh point. How to remove this seventh point? Seventh point is how to remove this yellow color of HNO3 can be removed by, first one it will be bubbling carbon dioxide into it. Okay, so carbon dioxide drives out NO2 and NO2 further oxidizes to give HNO3. Next one, adding water. So this is the entire summary of the laboratory preparation of HNO3.